Joseph Stalin, a selection from the 7th Enlarged Plenum of the ECCI. Zinoviev's manner of quoting reminds me of a rather amusing anecdote about the Social Democrats, which was related by a Swedish revolutionary syndicalist in Stockholm. It was in 1906, at the time of the Stockholm Congress of our party. This Swedish comrade and his story hit off very amusingly the pedantic manner in which some social democrats quote Marx and Engels, and listening to him, we, the Congress delegates, split our sides with laughter. This is the anecdote. It was at the time of the sailors' and soldiers' revolts in the Crimea. Representatives of the Navy and Army came to the Social Democrats and said, "For some years past, you've been calling on us to revolt against Tsarism. Well, we are now convinced that you are right, and we sailors and soldiers have made up our minds to revolt, and now we have come to you for advice." The Social Democrats became flurried and replied that they couldn't decide the question of a revolt without a special conference. The sailors intimated that there was no time to lose, that everything was ready, and that if they did not get a straight answer from the Social Democrats, and if the Social Democrats did not take over the direction of the revolt, the whole thing might collapse. The sailors and soldiers went away pending instructions, and the Social Democrats called a conference to discuss the matter. They took the first volume of Capital, they took the second volume of Capital, and they took the third volume of Capital, looking for some instruction about the Crimea, about Sevastopol, about a revolt in the Crimea, but they could not find a single, literally not a single instruction in all three volumes of Capital about either Sevastopol or about the Crimea, or about a sailors' and soldiers' revolt. They turned over the pages of other works of Marx and Engels, looking for instructions, but not a single instruction could they find. What was to be done? Meanwhile, the sailors had come expecting an answer. Well, the Social Democrats had to confess that under the circumstances, they were unable to give the sailors and soldiers any instructions. And so, our Swedish comrade ended, the sailors and soldiers' revolt collapsed. Undoubtedly, there is a good deal of exaggeration in this story, but undoubtedly, too, it lays its finger very neatly on the basic trouble with Zinoviev's manner of quoting Marx and Engels.